I do not know what is the situation insofar as funds for the Bahay Pangarap are concerned. You say, Bahay Pag-asa is concerned. You say there are 63 nationwide. 65. I do not know exactly what the situation in the budget is. But regardless of that, unless the chair has an idea of what the budget contains and if it's sufficient.
Mr. Chairman.
Oh, okay. My staff tells me that construction of Bahay Pag-asa, there is no appropriation.
That's correct.
Nothing in 2019.
For 2019?
Nothing.
Nothing. But this is even construction of Bahay Pag-asa. What I hear is
equipment.
Maintenance and equipment of the Bahay Pag-asa. We're not even talking of additional, just the existing. So what, can somebody give us an idea of what is needed?
Meron po tayong minimum standards kung ano po yung bahay, ano yung laman ng Bahay Pag-asa, ano yung mga programs doon. Kawawa po yung mga namomonitor namin sa Bahay Pag-asa. Meron po tayong konting ideal example, Valenzuela City, ang ganda po ng Bahay Pag-asa nila. For the rest, subhuman conditions, they lack the minimum staff requirement. They even lack food for children. Some of the Bahay Pag-asa we saw, mas malala po siya sa kulungan. Wala silang programs, wala silang beds, wala silang cabinets, walang, ang mga bata doon, they're just told to keep quiet the whole day and not do anything. So yung iba sa kanila, they do self-harm because they're very bored. So yun po yun. So talagang yung sa rehabilitation po yung nagiging problema natin. It's really not just the construction of Bahay Pag-asa, but we really need to budget, provide a budget to the local government units because they are the ones operating the Bahay Pag-asa.
We are, yung local government, dapat talaga, ang dami nilang ire, dapat maggawa sila dyan, di ba? Dapat nakasegregate. So siguro dapat sabihin natin doon na kailangan a certain amount of money from the IRA must be dedicated towards the effort to try and minimize the acts of juvenile crimes or and also rehabilitation.